to the Jim Bakker Show, coming to you from the village of Morningside, snuggled in the beautiful Ozark Mountains. Today, Jim's special guest, a tribute to Dottie Rambo with Larry Ferguson and Chris Barnes. Special music by Christian Ferguson. And I'm Kevin Shorey in the Morningside Band. Now direct from Grace Street in Morningside, here are your hosts, Jim and Larry Bakker. Wow.
Everybody, good to have you here. I'm telling you, this is quite an epic show today. We are going to literally see video of Dottie Rambo that is 30 years ago with me in the hair days. And you are going to meet right now. Here's Larry Ferguson back for the first time. Let me shake your hand here, Larry. Welcome back. Well, get that real close. Larry, it's so good to see you. This is the first time he's come out since the wreck where Dottie Rambo was killed.
Yes, not too far from here, actually.
That's right.
We were in Springfield Hospital for three and a half weeks, I think.
Wow. Yeah. And you were broke up.
Broke up from the floor up.
They
we
actually
were broke.
Put some makeup on you, forehead, and you
covering
can see
up
this,
all
the scars up in here where he was cut open and stapled back together, and your legs. What happened to your legs?
Well, the femur bone was totally destroyed. There wasn't any bone left, hardly. And so they filled all of this with cement, and I'm going to have to go and have a rib removed and graft that all out. This leg was broke, too. And then there's so many things that were wrong. I don't even know what all is wrong, but I have to use a wheelchair and I have five more surgeries I have to do.
Oh, my.
And use a wheelchair. I can use a walker some. And then I'll catch myself kind of holding on things, walking, and hear my kids yelling, use your walker. And usually you want to fall down after you hear somebody scream that at you.
But it is. I just thank God that you're here today. Yeah. I just praise God that both of you.
I thank God. I was telling Lori.
It's a miracle. You're a miracle.
Thank you. I was telling Lori, can I tell you this real quick, because these people might want to know this, that you all were doing your 4th of July celebration, and Dottie, every night at 3 o'clock, she'd be in her most excruciating pain as she would watch the Jim Bakker Show.
Yeah.
And so it was 3 o'clock, and I was flipping through, and the Jim Bakker Show was on. I said, I'm going to watch this, and you and Nancy Harmon and everybody. Mm. And I said, now I'm getting just a taste of what you had to walk through. Mm. But it lifted me up, seeing all of this, and I emailed Char about it, your mama. The agonizing pain she went through, and that you were there at 3 o'clock in the morning. See, people, that's when they hurt more, is at night than daytime.
That's right, Larry. That's right.
You need
truth.
To be there at 3 o'clock in the morning. Larry, I didn't need Lucy. I needed Jim and Lori.
Larry, and Lori. Larry is probably Dottie's best friend.
Yes.
He wrote a book called Driving Miss Dottie, yes, which we have talked about on our show. It's a fabulous book with pictures, and it's available at his website and online,
full of pictures.
But this is quite a book.
Yes.
But you knew Dottie so well, and you were family. Your children became her grandchildren.
Yes.
And she loved you and your wife so, so dearly.
Yes.
And we're going to talk a little bit about her homegoing. She went to be with the Lord, and we're going to talk about it today. We're going to share some things, and it is just unbelievable. Chris, it's good to see you.
Chris, you're a miracle.
Jim. So glad
Chris,
to see you.
Chris, it's a miracle. Yeah.
Chris Barnes,
walking
you have been Dottie's production director and helped produce products and email, or what do you call it, webmaster. I don't know what you call all that. Is that right?
I did that for about 5 or 6 years with Dottie. She was like a mother to me. So
yes.
It was.
You were in the wreck
of
the bus, and you don't remember anything about the wreck?
No. I was knocked out, so I don't remember much about it, which was a good thing, I guess, you know. That I don't
right.
How long were you knocked out?
I don't really even know. They kept me, once I got to the hospital, they kept me in a coma for 3 or 4 weeks. So I didn't
and
know
the
anything.
Doctors didn't give us much hope for you. I don't know
no,
if you knew that, but that's what they were telling us.
They thought I would be brain dead and so much because they just kept me, you know, keep me free from pain. They would keep me just, you know, medicated up. Mm-hmm.
But you're not brain dead, I'll tell you that.
Praise God.
We've been backstage talking. And we're so thrilled
Chris
to
is such a sweetheart.
Have you two here today.
Yes.
Larry, where were you the last service together? All of you were together.
Yeah.
And what was her last song?
The last song she sang was in Granite City, Illinois. And she sang, "We Shall Behold Him."
Aww.
And I mean, what an appropriate song. And she was talking a lot that night about going home, being sure, because that was her passion. She loved to do the concerts. She loved to do the things, you know, what do I call the clean, entertaining things. She did that. Mm-hmm. Preachers have to do that. You have to keep a captive audience.
Right.
But her heart was to get in and minister.
Yes.
And then that's when you've seen the tears flow. I've seen people so mean and just bawl after in the middle of a service that she was in.
She
but
just
that
opened
was
her hearts, didn't she?
She did. She knew. But I think she had been abused so much throughout her whole life that she could almost read what abuse you were going through and you were going through,
you know.
No matter what kind of abuse it was, she had almost been through it or close to it or had seen it in her family, you know, growing up in Kentucky in the hills and things like that, the things that happened. So she knew she could look right through you and tell you if you were lying. She could look a person down. I remember we were doing something with a huge television station. They were taking care of us. We had a great deal fixed up that we were going to do. And she wanted to back out of it at the last minute. We were there. And I said, this is a good godly man. We can't back out of this. This is going to kill us. She said, all right, I'm going to let you go ahead. But she says, it will backfire. And 2 days later, it all went up in flames. I mean, it was...
She knew.
So I always judged her character. She was right in judging character.
The thing is, God spoke to her.
Yes.
Her songs are from heaven.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
And we're going to hear a little bit from Dottie today. I know you're going to enjoy that. And in fact, right now, let's start the program with a song. You know, every one of her songs almost have come true in her life.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And as she wrote about going to heaven, she wrote about, "I'm going to leave here shouting."
Right.
Well, here she is from our program singing, "I'm going to leave here shouting." And she did. She was right there.
I've had my share of sorrows. I've walked the rocky road. I know what it means. I have a broken heart there. Here we go. I don't regret my journey. I've traveled here below. I'm gonna leave her shouting when my time comes to go. I'm gonna leave her shouting when I hit the promised land. If I'm too feeble to praise the Lord, lift up my dying hands. Amen. Over on wings as white as snow. I'm gonna leave her shouting when my time comes to go. I don't want nobody weeping when I draw my final breath. I fall asleep in the cradle of love and never feel the sting of death. So say a big hallelujah when I finally reach my goal. Cause I'm gonna leave her shouting when my time comes to go. Yeah, I'm gonna leave her shouting when I hit the promised land. If I'm too feeble to praise the Lord, just lift up my dying hand. Angels bear me over on wings as white as snow. I'm gonna leave here shouting when my time comes to go. I'm gonna leave here shouting. I'm gonna leave here shouting. I'm gonna leave here shouting when my time comes to go. I'm gonna leave here shouting when I head for the promised land. If I'm too feeble to praise the Lord, lift up my dying hands. Angels fairly over, on wings as white as snow. I'm gonna leave a shout when my time comes to go. I'm gonna leave a shout. I'm gonna leave a show. I'm gonna leave a shout when my time comes to go. For a show. Shout. Shout. Yeah.
The unsinkable Dottie Rambo. And I'll tell you, we're going to hear We Shall Behold Him by Dottie in a few minutes, the last song she sang on planet Earth. She left, you know, she talked about going to sleep and waking up in heaven. And basically, you were on the bus with her. She was, I understand she was in bed, sleeping.
She had a little suite in the back.
On the bus.
And what happened, the impact was so strong, she hit her vanity mirror and it broke her neck. Mm. So they said she couldn't feel anything. It just went, you know, so quickly. Mm. That was a story given to me. Now, that could be some error in that, but that was what was given
sure,
to me.
Sure, because you were out of it, too. You were knocked out at the beginning.
Yeah, we saw the crash happening. Me and my two children. My wife was in a bunk. But my two children, we were awake when it happened. Mm-hmm. And we saw
Judy's
the
here today. Let's give Judy a hand.
Strong woman.
And Judy.
And Christian.
And the kids are here today.
Christian and Pierce.
Judy has been, like, I call her Mother Teresa today. But she has been caring for all of you.
Yes. Yeah.
Even though, I think she broke her
shoulder.
Didn't she?
She broke her shoulder, and she would still lift me. And then when she couldn't, our friend Joyce and my friend Tennessee Michael, they came over and they were lifting me up and carrying me everywhere.
Aww.
And all these people really, you don't know how many friends you have. Mm. You really don't. You either learn two things when you're down, that nobody wants you when you're down, or that you have more friends than you realize when you're down.
Right.
And I think that that God allowed this to happen for a couple reasons. Dottie never would stop ministering.
Right.
I mean, if she was just in a hospital bed, we'd wheel her out here and she would still be ministering. Mm. She, as long as there was breath in her body. Mm. And I think this was the Lord's way of saying, okay, you've done enough.
Mm.
You, no more pain, no more. Because she would literally, she'd leave and we'd shut the room and we'd pray and we'd cry and we'd do. She would be in livid pain.
Mm.
But I noticed in the, which is odd to me, I noticed in the last several months before the death, she got stronger and bolder. Mm-hmm. And she, you know, I think the Lord gives us that last lion's roar, so to speak.
Yes.
And she was, we were in places and she was just
going
really
going
telling it how it was. Yeah. And
how
what
it was when she was here the last time with us. Remember the after show?
Yes.
And this woman, she just wanted to keep on preaching and preaching. And I mean, a couple hours had gone by. Yeah. It was amazing for those that were in the studio audience because we all got in on some wonderful ministry. Remember, Kevin?
I'll never forget it.
One of the most precious moments ever.
And see, she worked not for money. Now people say, oh, well, we paid you so much. The money, every dime that Dottie made on the road, every sale of whatever product we have, all went into her ministry.
Mm.
She didn't take a salary. Mm. She never took anything out of the ministry unless it was a ministerial need, you know, office needs or whatever. My salary came out of that, or reproductions of materials came out of that. Her stage clothing came out of that.
Mm-hmm.
But other than that, no salary. She said she told the Lord when she first saw her first royalty check, I'll never take money for singing and preaching from you again since you've taken such care of me with these songs.
Mm-hmm.
And she said,
That's
if
good.
These songs can take care of me, I won't use your money. Mm-hmm. I won't use God's people's money except to build the ministry.
Mm-hmm.
And she lived by that. And to the day she died, she never took a salary. Amazing. You know, or anything. We bought little things that she needed, you know, that on the road and things, you know.
You know, I have a question for you, too, that might, it's just not in the program, but it's, I just feel led to ask this. You know, being that you were in this horrific accident, and that you, both of your bodies were just completely busted up, along with, you know, others in the bus with you, do you still believe in God?
Oh, more than ever. More than ever. I don't believe I would be alive today if there was no God. I think it was more proof to me that there was a God, because my children did not get harmed. We were all banged out the windows. They were right there with us. One of the first things they told me was the highway patrol was questioning Pierce, the three-year-old, because he was the only one awake, you know, yes, coherent. And he said, well, it was just like a roller coaster at Dollywood, and it went down like this, and he explained it on. He goes, but right before it happened, my daddy grabbed me and Christian, his brother, and just started praying. And I prayed for them. I didn't, you know, my family didn't care what happened to me, and I prayed for Dottie to do what was best for her. If she had sustained these injuries, she could not have made it anymore.
The pain.
The pain would have been
I was told the autopsy doctor said they didn't know how she was a live woman.
Right.
With the condition her back was in. And that if she had survived, she would have had to undergo tremendous surgery, but they said it wouldn't work anymore.
No.
It was a miracle that she walked and talked and lived.
The point
God let her be with us 20 years after they said there was no much hope left for her.
And she still ministered 20 more years. In her life, I've seen God literally when she'd be at the point of death, rise her up from a bed. I do tell this in the book, but I don't tell this a lot. When Dolly and Dottie did the song together, Dolly's response was, sure, I'll do it. I'll let you know when I'm free to do it. And Dottie went into a terrible coma. Dolly's ready to do the song while she's in this terrible, just coming out of this terrible coma. I said, so Dottie, what I can do is just lay Dolly's part down and you can go in later. And she says, oh no. And we left the hospital 2 weeks early. They let her come. They said, are you going to take care of her? I said, yeah, I'll take care of her. She left the hospital 2 weeks earlier, went in that studio. She was on oxygen at the time. Oh. She said, I don't want Dolly to see this oxygen tank. Hide it.
Oh, and that sounds like her.
Her and Dolly did the song together. She was not, when she wrote the song Too Much to Gain to Lose, she really lived. Defeat is one word I don't use. She would march in here if there was somebody that did wrong by me, did wrong by Jim. She would face you with it. She went to her friends. She would go to battle for her friends.
She did.
We're going to make it peace right now. We're going to solve this.
That's the truth.
And that was one of her greatest points. And then that was one point that wasn't appreciated by a lot of people. You got a lot of wrongs in your life, or to her, they just didn't understand that. Just let it go. No, we're going to make it right. Letting it go wasn't of the Lord. We have to go to make it right with the enemies, and then we let it go.
Praise God. You know, thank you for that example. That's
your son Christian performed on stage, I guess, almost every night with Dottie. Is that right?
He did.
Could he do something for us on the show?
Yeah, he sure could.
So adorable.
He sang this at Granddot's funeral. They called her Granddot.
Right.
And come here. You want to come now?
Yeah.
Come on, Christian.
She went to...
Your mic's right over
there,
buddy.
Oh, there's yours.
Okay.
Pull it off.
How cute is he?
And you didn't get to go to the funeral.
I didn't, no, but he did.
But Christian was there and sang this song at Dottie's funeral.
And do all the moves Granddot taught you, too, because that's what I think is so funny.
Can you get the mic? You got enough cable there. Okay.
Okay. Here he is, Christian Ferguson.
One of Dottie's songs.
A lot of miles behind me, but home's a lot nearer. I got one more crossing. It's a long way over, so won't you stand by the river and wait for me? Stand by the river, Lord, and hold my trembling hand. Pray to me, sweet Jesus, from the cold I'm sinking sand. This small trip I can't take alone. I'm kind of anxious to get on home, so stand by the river and wait for me. You paved the road.
Ferguson, Stand by the River.
Great job, Chris.
What a Dottie Rambo great song.
What a great job.
That's the one Dolly Parton, I think, found by accident and recorded.
That's
it made a big hit
May
out
I
of it, isn't
say
it?
That right. I know for a fact how proud your granddaughter is of you, because one time I had the awesome opportunity to go on the bus with you guys after the show one day, and she said to me, my little grandson, Christian, sings with me all the time on the road. And I know that she's so proud of you. And you really did the moves.
That's
fabulous.
That's great.
And I love those
that's
moves.
Heritage. That's that Dottie Rambo heritage that lives on.
That's right
she's
there.
Dottie Rambo, we're not going to let her memory fade, because she is the writer of this generation of music.
Amen.
Now, we've moved our shipping department here. It is all here now. We've moved out, so it was so exciting to be here. But in moving all of the things, some of our friends were unpacking boxes, and we had videotapes, and they unpacked all the tapes that people have sent us. And there in the tapes was Dottie Rambo with me 30 years ago.
Oh my.
A tape that probably has not been played in 30 years. And usually they're brittle, they don't even work after 30 years.
Well, Chris wasn't even born yet. And I think you were just a year or two old by that time.
And so we took it, we found the old machine out in the truck, and it worked. We played it. Let's show just the first few minutes of PTL in 1978.
Wow.
30 years ago. And my guest was Dottie Rambo. Please roll a little bit of that.
Across America, with ministries around the world, the PTL Television Network presents on location the PTL Club. Originating today in the beautiful Christian Retreat Center on the banks of the Manatee River on the Gulf Coast of Florida. This is Music Emphasis Day on PTL in Florida. Our special guests today include the composer of such gospel favorites as His Name is Wonderful, To Be Used of God, and many, many others. From Gordy, California, Audrey Meyer. Also, two of the great composers and performers are here from Nashville, Tennessee, Dottie Rambo and Gary S. Paxton. And our host here at Christian Retreat, Gerald Erstein. Today's ministry musical feature, in addition to songs by Dottie Rambo, two of today's greatest gospel male soloists, Roger McDuff and Lee Robbins. I'm your announcer and co-host, Henry Harrison. And now, here's the host of the BTL Club, the president of the BTL Television Network, Jim Florida Sunshine, full of oranges, Bakker!
BTL, another great hour of music. Oh, you know, since Henry's been here, something's happened to him. And he's
got some knots.
Big warts breaking out on his back here. And they say it's from eating too many oranges. Have you heard that? You can eat too many oranges?
It's really from sitting too close to Jim Bakker.
Look at here. Look at there what happens to you. You just break out in oranges. Did you know that, Henry? Hey, these oranges are wet. There. You know, it's almost impossible to break Henry up when he's reading that intro. I don't know how he keeps a straight face and makes it through. Oh, it's nice to have all you here today.
Well, you really tried, Jim.
We get the funnies.
You're very trying.
Here in Florida. Here comes a bee back.
Here comes our bee.
They like to drink this lemon.
Mm-hmm.
The last bee in the last hour fell in and drowned it, though, so this bee better watch it.
Yeah, this is a different lemonade, though.
That's called too much of a good thing.
Yeah, it really is.
That's lemon with honey in it.
Oh, that sounds
good. There's honeybees.
There he goes.
He buzzed off.
Well, let's get things started today. More music this hour, and we have with us... Don't break Dottie up. She's got to sing now. Dottie and the Rambo delegation, I guess. I don't know what you call them. Dottie and her group. Please welcome Dottie Rambo.
Thank you, Jim. Thank you. What an audience. You're beautiful. Have you ever seen two little boys littler than these two, Jim and Henry? They don't ever grow up, do they? And I hope you never change. That's great. Really, I know. Jim, you're looking good. You're feeling better, I believe, than the last time I saw you.
Yeah.
The sunshine looks good on you.
Oh, it feels good to get some sun.
It's good to be with the Lord's people. How many love the man Jesus? Let me hear a big amen.
Amen. Amen.
All right. Why don't we give him a hand clap, everybody?
All right. You're great.
Amen. Let's do a song that talks about the stabilizing force, the firm foundation, the rock that we can build on, the lover of our soul, the lily of the valley, the bright morning star, our friend, our father, our mother, our provider, and we could go on for a long time. We're going to run out of time telling you about it. So we're going to sing about it, me and this conglomeration, Patty and Gary and Wendell and Dave, and we're talking about I go to that rock. Where can I turn when ain't nobody else I can turn to? And who am I gonna talk to when ain't nobody seem to want to listen? Who am I gonna lean on when there's no foundation stable? I'm going to the rock I know that's able. Going to that rock. Gonna go to the rock of my salvation. Going to the stone the builders rejected. Climbing up the mountain, oh, and the mountain standing by me. The earth all around me, Lord, is sinking sand, but oh, the solid rock I'm gonna stand. I need a shelter, I need a friend, so I go to the rock. And where can I hide till the storms have all passed over? Where am I gonna run to when those winds of sorrow threat on? Is there any refuge in your time of great tribulation? When my soul needs consolation, I go to that rock. Gonna go to the rock of
my salvation. Going to the stone, the builder rejected. Climbing up the mountain, God knows the mountain standing by me. Lord, it's sinking sand, but on Jesus, the solid rock I'm gonna stand. I need a shelter, sometime I need a friend, so I go to the rock. When there's trouble all around me and the cold wind keep a blowing, kind of like it's doing out here, when nobody understand me and I can't talk to nobody about my trouble. When I need money for the groceries and a car payment's due and a house needs paying for, and I need a new pair of shoes, Lord have mercy, I'm just making this up as I go. Lord, let me tell you what I do in times of trouble, when my mind is weary and my soul is tired and my body needs healing. Is everybody ready? Make me sound better. Gonna go to the rock of my salvation. Going to the stone that the builder rejected. Climbing up to my mountain, standing by me. When the earth all around me, Lord, is singing, saying, but oh Jesus, that rock I'm gonna stand. I need a shelter. Lord knows I need a friend, so I just go to the rock. And when I need a friend,
I go to the rock.
Need a little joy,
I go to the rock.
When nobody needs healing,
I go to the rock.
When I ain't got nobody love
I
me,
I
run away to a secret
I
place.
Never
talk to dear,
I go to the rock.
It feels so good to tell you, and I came all the way to Florida to tell you what I do. Simply gonna run. Jim, I said, I run. Everybody pray I hit this note. Lord, I'm gonna run. Jesus, that firm and silent rock. Run away, hide my face, cause I sure have loved to talk to that rock.
Yeah! Woo! Dottie Rambo on PTL at Christian Retreat down in Bradenton, Florida.
That was
is that
classic.
Good?
I loved that. Oh. I just reminded myself of Dottie. She loved it when I would say, I love that. She would always try to imitate me. But I really did love that. I figured she was 44 years old and you were 38.
Oh, my.
I was 14.
Had hair. But listen, this whole show that we just discovered that's been in the vault somewhere 30 years ago.
How we even
have
it is a miracle.
And you know what? The rest of it, I don't have time to show the other songs. And this is Dottie at her best. I mean, strong. Just
yeah, what
best.
A voice.
She sings a new song on this tape. It's called Holy Spirit, Thou Art Welcome.
Oh.
And it wasn't even big back then, 30 years ago. It just became the big hit, the classic. And she introduces it back here on this show. And she then sings other songs, and we get to talk and interview her. And then Roger McDuff is on this same show singing New Shoes.
How wild.
Dottie's song. Gary S. Paxton's on there singing. They all get together.
Oh, my.
And
Myers,
what's her name? Audrey Myers. One of the greats of all time.
The three
of them, Paxton, Dottie, and Myers, sit together and talk about their favorite songs that they've written. Just three of the greats of all time.
Wow.
He was there all the time. Of course, Gary Paxton's great thing. He was up. But they're all on this show. It's all music, and it's awesome.
Audrey Myers, his name is wonderful.
Oh,
yes.
I love that song.
The Monday Night Musicals in L.A. was a tradition. Kids nowadays don't even know.
I don't even know what that is.
Oh, it's just unbelievable. But
I'm not even a kid.
Here's what we're going to do today. Because every day, you know, we have to raise our budget to stay on the air. And every day we just believe God for a miracle. Well, here's what I made arrangements backstage. In fact, they've already got it ready to go.
Amazing.
It's called Dottie at PTL. And what we're doing, for a love gift of $25, you're going to get this epic video.
Oh.
It'll be better than we've seen on the screen. This was done about 30 minutes ago, raw, off the machines. It will be enhanced by the time you get it, that we can enhance it backstage and create a better video. The tape may not even ever play again, but we've got it duplicated to digital now.
Praise God.
Sometimes you only get one run out before the old tapes are brittle and they come apart on
you. Right,
but that is now safe for history.
Isn't that great?
And you can have a copy. Just ask for Dottie at PTL, and we're going to give you this show as well. We're going to give you 2 hours of video. We're going to give you the Dottie at PTL, and then we're going to give you this program that we're doing right now, so you can have Christian sing his great song on video.
Precious.
So you can have that along with all the other things that we're doing. What did you think, Larry? Because you were a baby when she was, you didn't even know her then.
No, I knew her when she got older, and of course that's what I love. But I love this because I actually have seen a lot of pictures from this show.
Really?
And that, a lot of people, the steel guitar player was Gary Chapman, that used to host Primetime Country on TNN.
Yeah.
It was Mary Damie Grant.
Oh.
So it's really
mom's
awesome.
My mom's in the audience.
But I grew
that
up watching
boy,
PTL.
That little boy, by the way, was Jamie Charles, that drummer.
So cute.
That's Jamie.
That was adorable.
We have footage, that's your footage, actually. You all premiered We Shall Behold Him, the musical, with an unknown Sandy Patty,
yeah.
Larnell
Sandy
Harris,
Patty.
And Dottie's walking around with the arranger. We have that. And I'll give that to you because you
might I'll give you, I'll trade
do
with
this.
You.
Yeah.
I'll
yes.
do this one.
You can have anything you want,
You
Larry.
Would love that to offer your partners.
Oh, that is
and
so...
Of course,
and
you know,
Dottie
people have to know
that.
The age of the... You know, the age of it. It's,
right.
it's not as crisp.
Right, sure.
But it's great.
Isn't it wonderful?
So if you want Dottie at PTL, just ask. It was written on the screen. Dottie Rambo at PTL.
Mm.
You can just say Dottie at PTL. We'll know what it means. And plus, we'll give you this copy of this program where you get to see these two guys, Larry back here and Chris, for their first appearances on television since the bus accident.
Really
and talking about
Thank
Dottie and those who are Dottie fans. And we can get these out because we actually make these in-house right now.
And
they're ready to go. And If you want, you can still get the Dottie Rambo story, the complete story, and you're on that a lot. We should actually show a piece of that with you. I don't know if we have any of that, but you do a lot of the Dottie Rambo story, and you're
so
really good on that.
I have to get a copy, so I'll know.
You can get that for a gift of $25. Just ask for the Dottie Rambo story. That's separate DVD.
And it's a good story.
It is.
And if you want all of that
right
video.
Here. Thank you.
Instead of $50, give $45 love gift and just say, I want the total Dottie Rambo package. And we'll give you both of them for a gift of $45 today.
But well, I'll tell you what, this is what Dottie would want, because one thing she would always say to Jim and Larry and Chris, you know this, every time she was here, she would say, Jim Bakker, don't be ashamed to ask for money to keep the program on the air.
Yeah.
Did she or did she not say that all the time, guys?
Did.
Every time.
She did.
Even behind the scenes.
At
she
home,
would get that finger going of hers.
She said, I'm going to reach through that TV set and shake him the next time he does that.
That's right.
She'd say that all the time. And she talked about the day. She said, PTL was the one network that did it right. When you came, they took care of their guests. They took care of the singers. People watched. I remember watching PTL before I was even a Christian. My grandmother was Catholic.
Wow.
We would sit and watch PTL. It was an entertaining ministry.
Yes.
Which is what we need. We don't need people promising Cadillacs.
Right.
We don't need people promising
that
you're going to fall on the floor if you do this. We don't need anything like that. Just real people with real stories. People are being lost because they're changing into the fads, and then we lose people like Betty Jean Robinson.
Aww.
And we lose these people like the Goodmans and all of that until a network shows come along and say, we want you because the people want you.
That's right.
Because Dottie sang songs like He Looked Beyond My Faults.
Yes.
And saw my needs. How many identify with that?
Yeah.
Anybody have faults in this crowd at all?
Oh, my Lord. The hands are up all over the crowd.
And that's what he's talking about, isn't it, Larry?
Exactly.
The last service with her, both of you, give me some memories of that very last service. Would you do that?
She was so anointed.
Mm-hmm. I can barely remember it.
Yeah, so. He had a lot of trauma to his head. He had a hard time. But she was so anointed that night. And she said, I want to do this song. I said, Dottie, you haven't done that song in forever. You're not going to remember that song. I want to do that song. I said, okay, well, whatever. So she was doing songs she hadn't done in years, pulling out old tracks, singing them. And people were just weeping and crying, and they stayed through a storm. We're talking about now, you can't get many older people to sit through a storm to see anybody.
Sure.
Right,
and they came during the storm and sat through the storm and went through the storm. But she was so anointed. She started praying for people, laying hands on people. And she didn't want to knock anybody in the floor. Not that everybody does that. I'm not meaning that.
Right.
Because there's certainly reasons for that. People perceive it the wrong way. My mouth dry, excuse me. But she wanted to touch the point of contact.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And she always said untouchable, unusable.
Untouchable, unusable.
And one thing she told Jason Crabb that he remembers till this day, she said, remember, everybody you meet coming up that ladder, you're going to meet when you fall down the mountain. Be nice to all of them.
Wow. That's a good word.
Oh, that's beautiful. And the last song she sang,
We Shall Behold
Him. We Shall Behold Him.
We Shall Behold Him.
And she did. She went to bed on the bus and woke up in heaven.
That's right.
And that's exactly what she sang. I mean, how many songs are about tears will never stain the streets of that city?
Never been this homesick before.
Yeah.
Sheltered safe in the arms of God.
Safe in the arms of God.
Let the storm clouds rise.
And it was always, I'm going to leave that storm. And she went to heaven in a storm.
Wow.
The rainy night,
exactly.
A stormy night.
Yeah.
The concert was even in a storm.
Yes, she sang that night so much about storms, too. That was in the paper. I forgot about that. We've weathered storms before. There's another song about
pass.
Storms. It Will Pass, which that's the one you all loved when she just dug it out and debuted it here on the show.
Yes, I love it.
And she sang all these songs about storms, and then all of a sudden we were hit with one.
Wow.
I mean, you thunder, lightning, and everything through the service. But she always said she was ready to go. She didn't want to go this early because she had work to do. And she said to me, now when I go, you just, so maybe I'll go before you, I was hoping. Because it's very hard when you devote your whole life to somebody.
Can't even imagine.
You don't know, it's like being married, really. And she'd say, well, maybe we'll go up together and I'll hold on to your bootstraps.
Aww.
And so that's how the hardest part is just not knowing you can't talk to them again.
Right.
That you can't see them again. Because in a sense, we were in a marriage.
Yes.
Different type of marriage, of course.
Right.
But we were, so there's still some battles.
Right.
And, you know, we're still trying to keep our ministry going. And there's things we've got to do that. But God is going to be victorious.
Yes.
God is, I believe that in the United States of America, that your wishes should be honored, no matter who you are. And her last wishes should be honored. Her ministry should be carried out.
And her wish was that you handle all of her ministry. She actually willed her ministry to you.
Yeah.
And asked you to carry on. And that's what you're trying to do right
that's
now.
That's what I want to do.
In the midst of the brokenness. But God's going to heal you totally. I know that.
Yes.
And you're already getting better.
That's right.
Raise you up.
And hold no bitterness. Hold no bitterness against the people. They don't know what they're doing.
Right,
and you and your wife, who's here with us, and your two kids, you were Dottie's family.
Absolutely.
On the road, at home,
live next
all
door
over.
To each other.
And
she told
was
me that
with her
over
that
over.
Last night as she sang that great concert in the midst of a storm. And I want her to sing this song from our archives. This last song Dottie Rambo ever sang on earth, We Shall Behold Him.
Praise God.
And she's there now.
unfold, preparing his entrance. Oh my goodness. And the stars will do their shall applaud him with thunders of praise. The sweet light in his eyes shall enhance those waiting. And we shall behold him then face. Amen.
Hallelujah.
We shall behold him. Sing it with me now. We shall behold him face to face. Don't stretch it. In all of his glory, we shall behold him. What a day that's going to be.
Hallelujah.
We shall behold him face to face, our Savior. I love this verse. I wrote it for Mom. The angels shall sound the shout of his coming. Hallelujah. And the sleeping shall rise from their slumbering place. And those who remain shall be changed in one moment. Sing now. And we shall behold him then face to face. We shall behold him. We shall behold him face to face in all of his glory. Oh, we shall.
Dottie Rambo.
Beautiful.
Dottie was 74 years old. I finally can give you her age because
the papers did.
She never allowed it. And of course, it's been in all the papers now. But she never would give her age. Mm-hmm. And but she was 74 years old, and a dear friend, yes. dear friend, writer of these great gospel songs.
Yes.
Father, I just pray that her songs will lift people up today.
Yes.
Lord, there's those who are lonely, and they need to know that you'll never leave them,
right,
and that you will never forsake them.
Thank you.
God, you said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest.
Yes.
Dottie was weary, Lord, but she kept on going to the last moment. Yes. She sang this song moments before she went to be with you.
Yes.
She was faithful through it all. Oh God, I pray now for those listening and hearing this program, God, that you will lift those up that are weary, that are going through pain or sickness, Lord. Touch them today, God. We agree in prayer for them right now. You know, the Word of God in Hebrews chapter 4, and I wanted to share more this week about God's rest. We are to rest in Him. Hebrews 4:8 says, we know that Joshua did not lead the people into that rest because God spoke later about another day. This shows that the rest for God's people is still coming. Anyone who enters God's rest will rest from his work as God did. Now, Dottie is in the total rest of God. But God wants you to rest. He wants you. I don't know if I need a different microphone or not. Mine is fading in and out. But let God,
yes,
come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden.
He says, he maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He gives you rest. Commit it to God today. Commit it to God. Father, we pray for people to have hope. Lord, we pray for those that were in the accident, Lord. Everyone, Lord, that you will heal them, Lord. Lord, you took Dottie home. For some reason, it was her time to go. And now she's singing in heaven. God bless those today that are heavy laden. Lord, bless those that feel like somehow they have faults too big for you to take care of. But let the words of Dottie's song, he looked beyond my faults and saw my need. Oh God, I pray in Jesus' name that every person watching will one day walk the streets of heaven with Dottie Rambo,
yes,
and the angels in heaven. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you so much for being here. We're so thrilled that Larry could come back again to be with us, and Chris.
Thank you.
We're looking forward to having him back again. And we want to really share some of the fun things and the great stories of Dottie again.
We could do a lot of shows together, couldn't we? Don't forget, you can call our 800 number and get this, the Dottie Rambo story.
That's the total, Dottie Rambo package right there. That's the story. Mm-hmm. Today's broadcast, mm-hmm, with all the guests here, mm-hmm, and the very PTL special lost episode of PTL, that for $45 love gift, you can get both of those. But if you'd like just the new one, well, the old Dottie Rambo story, which not that old, but it is such a great,
so
great epic. Mm-hmm. You can get that for $25 gift. Or if you want Dottie at PTL, just ask for Dottie at PTL for a love gift of $25 to help us stay on the air. Or you could do more if you'd like. And you can write in Branson, Missouri at Box 7330, 65615. And we'll give you today's broadcast. So you'll have these songs that we just put on the air on there. And you'll get to hear Christian sing. And you're going to get to have all the other things that we talked about, Dottie.
So sweet.
For those who love Dottie. But we want to give you this special lost episode today. Dottie at PTL. Just ask for Dottie at PTL with your love gift of $25. And that will mean so much to us
and I know you're going to have fun. I mean, there is so much on there. I mean, when you figure there's the Holy Spirit, Thou Art Welcome, it was kind of a new song back there and hadn't even become the great hit that it is today. But she sang a lot of her other songs on here, and get to hear her talk about her favorite songs. And you'll get to hear Roger McDuff sing New Shoes and another song, and Gary Paxton sing one of his songs. And this is kind of walking down memory lane and then hearing these three great songwriters talk about their favorite songs of all time. Okay. This is not available anywhere on earth but through us today, and history in the making. Dottie at PTL, just ask for that with your love gift of $25.
Don't forget, you can go into your Christian bookstores, or you can go to Larry Ferguson at DottieRambo.net, and you can pick up this book. That is a fabulous book.
It's called
book.
Driving Miss Dottie.
Driving Miss
and
Dottie.
We have some still that Dottie has signed along with me at the Larry at DottieRambo.net.
Okay.
And you can still get those too. Good. I forgot. Judy found a whole couple boxes.
Oh, great. You'll send them. We'll send those out. Okay.
The show is over, but we're just getting started. The next generation of broadcasting is on our website. Visit us at www.jimbakershow.com to join our iFamily network. You can be a part of the interactive after show with Jim and Lori and enjoy all new Morningside events. Broadcast live via the internet, our powerful seminars, amazing concerts, and much more. Coming soon to Morningside. Exploring Heaven with Rose Martin. Seminars August 6th and 7th at 3 p.m. The Ascension Quartet, August 22nd at 7 p.m. Spoken For Quartet, August 29th at 7 p.m. If you'd like to write to Jim and Lori, send a letter to P.O. Box 7330, Branson, Missouri, 65615. That address again is P.O. Box 7330, Branson, Missouri, 65615. To order today's special gift and help keep us broadcasting around the world, you can call us now at 1-888-988-1588. That number again, 1-888-988-1588. Or write us at P.O. Box 7330, Branson, Missouri, 65615. Don't forget to send us your prayer request for the Wall of Agreement. That address again is P.O. Box 7330, Branson, Missouri, 65615. Lori's Wardrobe is provided by the Grand Glitz, located at the Branson Landing. Unique as normal at the Grand Glitz. Welcome to the Foxborough Inn and Suites, located next to the new Sight and Sound Theater, featuring newly remodeled hotel rooms, deluxe 1 and 2 bedroom condominium suites, and a refreshing outdoor pool. The Foxborough Inn is the hotel of choice for guests appearing on The Jim Bakker Show. Thank you for your prayers and support that help keep us broadcasting around the world.